Let's get started with doing the meditation as we usually do. And today I was asked to do a death contemplation for the meditation, so we'll do that this morning. And so just follow along, and if you don't enjoy it or you find it is too much or whatever, then just opt out and just watch your breath or do whatever else you like. It's important to be comfortable with these things. If it is too challenging, then it can be a negative experience. So just make sure you enjoy these things. Okay, so let's get going here. Okay, so whenever you do meditation of any kind, it doesn't matter what kind of meditation it is always important to start off by stabilizing the mind and the body, relaxing, allowing things to calm down, and then gradually allowing the mindfulness to establish itself. Meditation really only happens when mindfulness is reasonably clear. So it's important always to start out by establishing mindfulness first of all. A sense of clarity, a sense of peace in the mind, when you're able to follow along easily. And as you do this kind of meditation, we're just letting go of the world. Just notice how delightful it is just to leave everything behind. There's nothing left in the whole world, just you and your breath and your awareness, and there's nothing else. And just feel the ease of that, how light it is, how there's no willpower involved. You're just enjoying being peaceful. The more you can incline your mind in this way, the more you will enjoy the meditation practice. And now let us take the meditation in a slightly different direction. And just to start out, just imagining yourself, you are lying on a bed. You're lying on a bed inside a room. And this room that you are lying in is a very simple room. There is nothing in there of any interest at all. All the walls are bare. The walls are white. The ceiling is white. There is no window. There's nothing inside this room except for you lying on the bed. The door is closed and there's no sounds or anything coming from the outside. You have like maybe a white kind of garment covering your body and you're lying on your back looking at the ceiling and the ceiling is all also white. There's nothing at all happening here. Everything is very simple. And you're lying on your deathbed. You know that within maybe just a few hours, you will be dead. This will be the end of your life. How does that feel? And just make a mental note of what it feels like that you're going to die in a very short time. And just put that aside for now. And then we come back to the furthering this contemplation. And you know that the time of your death, the time of your departure is getting closer and closer. And you know that you will not be meeting any people, anyone in the whole world before you die. You're by yourself and you're on this journey, very interesting journey, moving on into the unknown. And as you get closer and closer to the moment of death, you realize that you're going to have to abandon all the things in this life. And the most obvious thing that you're going to have to abandon is all the possessions in this life. And all those possessions includes, of course, your house. It includes all the things that are most dear to you. Even the clothes that you have, all and everything is going to be given up. How does it feel to give up all your possessions? And as you are lying in this very simple room, there is nothing happening here. It's only you and nothing else. And you're getting closer and closer to the time of your departure. And as you are abandoning your possessions, it is as if the world is fading into the background. The world starts to seem less important. And as you get closer, you realize that there's even more things that you have to let go of. One of the main things that you have to leave behind is all the people in this world, all your friends, all your acquaintances, all your family members, even the people who are closest to you. Now is the time to say goodbye in your heart, and you have to go your separate ways. So say goodbye to all the people in the world. And again, notice what that feels like. And as you are gradually letting go of the world in this way, you realize that the point of death is coming closer and closer. There's probably less than an hour left now of your life. And as you get closer, you realize that there is even more that you have to let go of in this life. You realize that so much of your identity, your personality, is tied up with this world, your social position, your position in the family, your wealth, what you look like, your nationality, your background, all of these things are tied to this world. Now that you are approaching your death, it is as if you have to abandon all of these personal characteristics, and all that is left inside are the good qualities that you can carry with you into the future. So feel what that feels like. And as you abandon all of these personal characteristics that are tied up with this world, you start to feel this beautiful emptiness inside. It's as if you are emptying out all of this content that actually is quite meaningless. And when you empty out so much of this identity of who you think you are, what is left is this beautiful emptiness. This beautiful peace within her, and all that is there are the good qualities that you have built up during this life. To see if you can experience that emptiness within her, the emptiness when we let go of all of these personal things that are tied to this world. And as you empty out in this way, you're getting even closer to the moment of your death. It is now only minutes away. You're getting very, very close to the end. And you realize that there is even more that you have to abandon on this journey towards the end of your life. And one of the last things you have to abandon is your body. The physical body has to be left behind. So give up your attachment to the body. Give up to holding on to this material form. And then carry on. Move on towards the end of your life without having any attachment and holding to the body. And you feel so unburdened. All the burdens of the world have been left behind. All you have is this beautiful sense of peace and emptiness inside. You feel like just a cloud drifting through the sky. All the burdens having been left behind. And there comes a point in this process, you don't even know whether you are dead or alive. You're just leaving things behind, and you realize it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter whether you are dead or alive, because this process of letting go is so beautiful and delightful. All you do is enjoy the process of letting go. And as you come to understand the delight of this process, the delight of letting go, the delight of just feeling stillness and emptiness inside, when you see the beauty of this process, you start to wonder, why was I ever afraid of dying? Dying is a wonderful thing. It is not really problematic. And as you move on into the unknown and the future, you realize that the reason why you can have this beautiful experience at the very end of your life, the reason you can have that is because of all the kalyana mittas that you have had in your life, all the good friends, all the good people who have supported you and shown you the right direction, the Dhamma, the Buddha, the monks, the lay people, everyone coming together. And you start to feel this enormous sense of gratitude. You have this gratitude that you can experience this wonderful ending of your life. And it is because of the help of other people. You have this enormous sense of gratitude for all these people in your life. In fact, you feel gratitude to the whole world for making this possible. And because you have this gratitude to the whole world at this very end of your life, you start to feel a sense of metta, a sense of kindness and friendliness to all the beings in the world, because you realize how they actually have supported you in this final process. All the people in the world, all the beings, may you all be well, may you all be happy. And now please come back to your breath, come back to just stay with your breath for a few minutes until the end of the meditation. Okay, so coming to the very end of the meditation, before we come to the end, once again, take a few moments just to see how you feel now. And if you do feel more at ease and relaxed, if you feel more positive in one way or another, ask yourself why that is the case.